Good morning, Ananda. Now, first of all, I want to invite Professor Shara Nizza to start this webinar with a word of prayer.
Prayer. Dear loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wonderful day you have given us. Lord, before the start of this webinar, we are all gathered in your mighty feet for your blessings, guidance, and support. Lord, enrich the resource person with your knowledge so that she will use her potentials fully, Lord. We also pray for the participants. Help them to make use of this webinar effectively. Finally, Lord, we pray for all the people who are supporting you to conduct this webinar. Bless us and guide us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, ma'am, for your prayer. Now it's my time to welcome you all for this webinar, Cloud Insights. Now, it's my immense pleasure to welcome our chief guest, that is the resource person of the day, Mrs. Sherin Debos. Ma'am, about the resource person, so she is now currently working as manager of products in projects in Cape Germany, India. She is having 10 years of experience in this field. She did many automations and optimizations and value adds. And also, she did 29950 AUD savings through a process automation to A and Z, and 5,000 USD savings per month for AT&T. Above all, she got the Best Employee Awards for 3 times and Orient Excellence Award from IBM, and also the Best Behind the Scene Award from A and Z. Ma, we really feel very happy to have you as resource person of this day. Now, over to our resource person, Mrs. Sherin Cynthia Jayos.
Thank you so much, ma'am, Benita, and thank you, ma'am Jennifer, for having organized and invited me for this session. I thank both you and thank God, Almighty God, for this wonderful opportunity for having been as one of the resource persons among people among your side. So I'd like to wish you all a very happy good morning and a very happy day. Let this day be a very great blessing and a nice day to you all. With this, I would like to start up with the session. I'll be sharing. I know it is like, you know, a lot of webinars have been happening, and you know, I myself have been seeing that all the webinars are circling around cloud technologies. And why is that so? So it is because the next decade is going to circle completely around cloud technology, and cloud is going to be one of the very top-notch technologies in this whole industry, IT industry, I would say. So with this brief introduction about how it is going to benefit the world for at least another one more decade, minimum at least 10 years, cloud will be the technology giant of this IT world. Okay, so this gives me a very good enthusiasm or excitement to speak about cloud. You would have heard that almost all or most of the webinars are circling around, but hold on, the thing is, yenada cloud வந்து எல்லாருமே இது பண்ணாலும் உண்மையிலே cloud வந்து next 10 years க்கு இட்ஸ் கோயிங் டு பி ரூலிங். அதனால தான் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி வெபினார்ஸ் ஆர் சர்க்கிளிங் அரவுண்ட் cloud. அப்போ cloud மட்டும் பார்க்காம நெக்ஸ்ட் வரப்போற 10 இயர்ஸ்க்கு நம்ம cloud வந்து என்னென்ன மாதிரிலாம் cloud வந்து யூஸ் பண்ணலாம், எல்லாரும் cloud cloudங்காங்களே, பட் ஹவு டு யூஸ், ஹவு டு யூட்டிலைஸ் திஸ் cloud கம்ப்யூட்டிங் டெக்னாலஜிஸ், எப்படி இந்த 10 வருஷத்துல நம்ம அந்த அட்வான்ஸ்மெண்ட்ஸ் இருக்க முடியும். ஏன்னா ஒவ்வொரு செகண்ட் ஆர் ஒவ்வொரு 2 மினிட்ஸ்க்கும் யூ நோ தட் வென் அமேசான் இஸ் டெலிவரிங் அ கோட் இன் ப்ரொடக்ஷன், ஓகே, அதெல்லாம் ஒரு 5 வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடி அது ஒரு அசாத்தியம் இல்லாத ஒரு காரியமா இருந்துச்சு. பட் நவ் இட் இஸ் ஆல் ஹேப்பனிங் that you know each and every second some things are getting developed, and each and every technology, be it code related to Python or be it something related to the databases or DevOps, even the DevOps was a big boom. ஆனா இதெல்லாம் எப்படி சார்ந்து இருக்குது ஒன்னொன்னு ஒண்ணு, இட் இஸ் ஆல் இன்டர் ரிலேட்டட், அது வந்து நம்மளுக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கணும். சோ இட் இஸ் ஆல் ஐ ஹட் I do not know that, you know, last webinar, where our college learned, I do not know if you had the opportunity to been there, you would have got to know that I have been emphasizing this, because connecting the dots is more important. Nariya technology therinjirkalam, nariya nama learn pannirkalam, ana onnodu onnu eppadi interlink aagudhu, how the beats are connected towards the string abdingiradhu nammalku therinjirkanum. Adu therinja mattum dhaan எப்படி இந்த ஐடி உலகம் இயங்குது, எப்படி இந்த என்டர்பிரைசஸ் எல்லாம் ஒர்க் பண்றாங்க, எதுக்கு அந்த எண்ட் யூசர்ஸ், நம்ம எல்லாம் எண்ட் யூசர்ஸ், வி ஆர் தி ஸ்டேக் ஹோல்டர்ஸ், நம்ம இல்லைன்னா பிசினஸ் இல்லை, ரைட்? ஸோ அந்த நார்மல் பர்சன், நார்மல் மேன் இஸ் த ஃபைனல் எண்ட் யூசர் ஆர் த ஸ்டேக் ஹோல்டர் ஃபார் எனி ப்ராடக்ட் ஆர் எனி டெக்னாலஜியில. எப்படி அந்த எண்ட் யூசருக்கு இந்த டெக்னாலஜி எல்லாம் யூஸ் ஆகுது அப்படிங்கறது நம்ம வந்து தெரிஞ்சுக்கணும். ஸோ to go directly into the topic of cloud insights. So insights na vera onnum illa, eppadi namma vande adha andha moola koorugalai eppadi purindhu eppadi cloud vande nammalku work cloud vande nammalku work panna vaikka pogirom வர்ற 10 ஆண்டுகள்ல. இதுதான் வந்து நான் சொல்ல போறது. இந்த ஒரு மேபி க்ளோஸ் டு 45 to 50 மினிட்ஸ் ஐ வில் பி டேக்கிங் திஸ் செஷன். போஸ்ட் தட் வி வில் ரேப் அப் வித் சம் ஃபியூ க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் ஆர் சம்திங். இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு நோ, யூ கேன் ரீச் அவுட் டு மீ எய்தர் த்ரூ த சாட் விண்டோ ஆர் வி கேன் கன்வர்சேட். ஓகே, ஸோ வித் நோ ஃபர்தர் டிலே ஐ வுட் லைக் டு ப்ரெசென்ட் சம் ஆஃப் த ஸ்லைட்ஸ் தட் ஐ ஹேட் ப்ரிப்பேர்ட், பிகாஸ் இட்ஸ் குட் டு நோ, சி அண்ட் நோ, ரைட்? I'll be sharing my screen. Let me know once you see my screen. Benita ma'am or Jenny ma'am, could you please confirm that if you are seeing my slide again, once again,
please? Yes, Karen, it is visible.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Okay. So with some introduction, last time I was I would like to put forth this same example, because I do not know, many people would have attended or would not have attended. The thing is how to easily understand about a cloud na vera onnume illa. Ipo nama lockdown period laye ella I had quoted the same example so that people were able to relate their own lifetime things and they understand it easily. So cloud na vera onnum illa, adhavu namma oorla eppadi ooruku or ration kada irukudo, ella saligaigal, ella free goodies government la irundhu varradhu ella அந்த ரேஷன் கடையில இருந்து ஒவ்வொருத்தருக்கும் இட் இஸ் அவைலபிள், ஒவ்வொரு ஊருக்கும் அவைலபிள் அப்படின்னு இருக்குதோ, அதே ரேஷன் கடையை ஒவ்வொரு வீட்டுக்கும் ஒவ்வொரு ரேஷன் கடை, நீங்க உங்க இல்ல ஒவ்வொரு வீட்டுக்கும் ஒரு ஏடிஎம் மிஷினே வச்சுக்கோமா, எப்பப்ப தேவையோ அப்பப்ப போய் காசு வித்ரா பண்ணிக்கலாம்ப்பா, யூ கேன் எப்பப்ப நீங்க டெபாசிட் பண்ணணுமோ பண்ணிக்கலாம், ஒரு பக்கத்துல வீட்டு பக்கத்துலயே ஒரு ரேஷன் கடை வச்சுக்கலாம், நீங்க எப்ப பண்ணுமோ ஃப்ரீயா போய் அரிசி பருப்பு எல்லாம் வாங்கிக்கலாம். இது எல்லாம் இந்த மாதிரி எல்லாம் நம்ம த்ரூ இன்டர்நெட், அதான் கிளவுட் அப்படிமாங்க, இன்டர்நெட் வந்து இங்க கிளவுட் அப்படின்னு சொல்றாங்க, சரியா? த்ரூ இன்டர்நெட் என்னென்ன இந்த மாதிரி லைக் அரிசி பருப்புனா வேற ஒன்றுல டேட்டா பேசஸ் அண்ட் யுவர் கம்ப்யூட்டிங் சர்வீசஸ் லைக் ஒரு மணி கால்குலேஷன்ஸ், பிட் யூனோ த பிட்காயின் ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸ், ஒரு டேட்டா சர்வர் கனெக்டிவிட்டி, நெட்ஒர்க்கிங் கனெக்டிவிட்டி, ஒரு ஆர்டிஃபிஷியல் இன்டெலிஜென்ஸ், ப்ளஸ் ஒரு யூஐ யூசர் இன்டர்ஃபேஸ், ஒரு அப்ளிகேஷன், எல்லாமே இட் இஸ் அவைலபிள் டு யூ. இந்தாங்க இதுதான் உங்க வீட்டுக்குள்ளே எல்லாமே இருக்குது அப்படின்னு கையில கொண்டு வந்து கொடுத்தா எவ்வளவு நல்லா இருக்கும், எவ்வளவு ஈஸியா இருக்கும். ஈஸ் ஆஃப் யூஸ் அகெயின், ஸோ எவ்வளவு ஈஸியா இருக்கும், எவ்வளவு என்னென்னலாம் நம்ம பண்ணலாம், இதுதான் கிளவுடு. ஸோ வேற ஒண்ணுமே இல்லை, கிளவுட் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் மேக்கிங் இன்ஃப்ராஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் ஆர் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம்ஸ் ஆர் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் available to each and every subscriber through internet over a period, very little period, means in the matter of a second or a minute, to the end user is called cloud. Okay, so cloud is verona perusa id panana idu dhaan cloud, ellame nammaloada everything is now coming into hands, ella nama kai ketra durathile dhaan irukudu, nama thoughts etra durathile dhaan irukudu. ஸோ அப்படி இதில் பார்க்க போனதுல தான் இப்போ ஒரு நல்ல ஒரு எக்ஸாம்பிள் கோட் பண்ணோன்னா, நம்ம இப்போ மீட்டிங் இது பண்ணுறது எல்லாம் மெயினாக ஜூம் வீடியோ இஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி ஆன் கிளவுட்ஸ், சரியா? அப்புறம் நம்மளோட கூகுள் டிரைவ்ஸாக இருக்கட்டும், இல்லை கூகுள் பிக்சர்ஸ், கூகுள் டாக்ஸ் ஆர் எனி திங், இப்ப எல்லாருமே மக்களுக்கு வந்து முந்தி முந்தி இருந்த காலங்கள்ல வந்து ரொம்ப செக்யூர்டா வச்சிருப்பாங்க, அதுக்குன்னு ஒரு பெரிய கேட் போட்டு மூடி அது ஒரு நெட்ஒர்க் செக்யூரிட்டிக்குள்ள வச்சு அதை வந்து யாருக்கும் எக்ஸ்போஸ் பண்ணாம டேட்டா எல்லாம் எக்ஸ்போஸ் பண்ணாம அப்படி வச்சிட்டு இருந்தாங்க. ஆனா அதனால யாருக்கும் யூஸ் இல்ல, அதாவது கம்மியான பீப்புளுக்கு தான் யூஸ் ஆகுது, ஒரு பெரிய க்ரௌடுக்கு யூஸ் இல்லங்கிறது தெரிஞ்சு போச்சு. அதனால சோ எவ்ரி கிளவுட் ரிலேட்டட் ஸ்டப்ஸ், அதாவது எல்லா ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸ் ஆர் கெட்டிங் டு த எண்ட் யூசர்ஸ் யூசேஜ் த்ரூ த இன்டர்நெட். தட் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் இன்டர்நெட்டை தான் இங்க வந்து ஒரு கிளவுட், அதாவது பேஸ்ட் ஆன் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கோடிங்ஸ் ஆர் சம்திங், இட் இஸ் ஆல் அவைலபிள். ஸோ இட் இஸ் ஆல் இன்டர்லிங்க் டுவர்ட்ஸ் ஈச் அதர். அது நம்மளுக்கு கொடுக்கறது தான் இந்த கிளவுட் டெக்னாலஜி. ஸோ இப்போ இந்த கிளவுட்லேயே இப்போ டிஃப்ரெண்ட்டாக அப்போ நம்ம எங்கப்பா அப்போ நீங்கள் எல்லாத்தையுமே எல்லாருக்கும் எக்ஸ்போஸ் பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னா தென் டேட்டா செக்யூரிட்டி கம்ஸ் இன்டு பிக்சர். எவனாலும் எதனாலும் எப்படினாலும் யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாம். So security comes into picture. So security, yes, in cloud it was a little bit hiccup, but now people have written lot of firewall codings or and the nama networking security adu ellame strengthen pannirukanga. Now vara vara cloud computing is going to be the very big secured gateway for each and everything. ஓகே, அப்போ அதனாலதான் அப்போ கிளவுட் கம்ப்யூட்டிங்னு எடுத்துக்கிட்டேன்னா அப்போ இந்த செக்யூரிட்டி இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் த மோஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் இன்சைட்ஸ் அகெயின். ஓகே, ஸோ இப்போ எல்லாமே எல்லாருக்கும் அவைலபிளா இருக்கும்போது செக்யூரிட்டி கம்ஸ் இன்டு பிக்சர். அப்போ டாப் யூசர்ஸ், அதாவது இப்போ நம்மளுக்கு பரவலா தெரிஞ்ச வரைக்கும் நிறைய கிளவுட் சர்வீஸ் ப்ரொவைடர்ஸ் இருக்காங்க. ஆனா கூகுள் கிளவுட் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் GCP அப்படிமாங்க, இல்ல அமேசான் வெப் சர்வீசஸ் AWS அப்படிமாங்க, அண்ட் மைக்ரோசாஃப்ட் அஷ்யூர். ஸோ மூன்று பெரிய ஐடி ஜாம்பவான்கள் கிரியேட் பண்ண இந்த கிளவுட் என்டர்பிரை கிளவுட் அந்த ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸை தான் இந்த மாதிரி நம்ம நேம் பண்ணுறோம், GCP, AWS அண்ட் மைக்ரோசாஃப்ட் அஷ்யூர் கிளவுட். ஓகே, ஸோ அப்போ இதில் பார்க்க போனப்போ எல்லாருக்கும் கொஞ்சம் பரவலாக ரொம்ப நல்லா தெரிகிறது இண்டஸ்ட்ரியை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும், ஆறு இல்லை தனி மனிதர்களை பற்றி தெரியும் போது AWS எல்லாருமே சொல்கிறோம். ஏன் அப்படின்னா அமேசான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட், இட் இஸ் ஆல் அகெயின் டைட் டு பிஸ்னஸ் டாக்டிக்ஸ் சரியா. அப்போ அமேசான் வந்து ஸ்டார்டட் ஆஸ் அ புக் செல்லிங் கம்பெனி ஃபர்ஸ்ட். எத்தனை பேருக்கு தெரியும், அவர் ஜெஃப் பெசோஸ் வந்து புக்ஸை தான் செல் பண்ணிட்டு இருந்தார், ஒரு சும்மா ஒரு வெப்சைட்டை வச்சு ஹி ஸ்டார்டட் செல்லிங் புக்ஸ். அதுக்கப்புறமா படிப்படியா ஒய் டோன்ட் வி செல் மல்டிபிள் அதர் குட்டீஸ், அதாவது மற்ற வேற பொருட்கள்லாம் நம்ம செல் பண்ணான அப்படின்னு ஆரம்பிச்சு, அது ஒரு 10 வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடியே அமேசான், அதாவது மோர் தென் ஃபிஃப்டீன் இயர்ஸ் இட் ஹஸ் கம் இட் சீம்ஸ். ஆனால் நம்மளுக்கு எல்லாம் தெரிஞ்சது இட்ஸ் பீன் இந்த ஒரு 7 to 8 இயர்ஸ்க்குள்ள தான் அவங்களோட ஹை பீக், ஹி பிகேம் த நம்பர் ஒன் ரிச்சஸ்ட் பர்சன் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட் அண்ட் அமேசான் ஹேஸ் பிகம் த ரிச்சஸ்ட் த டாப் மோஸ்ட் எக்கனாமி ஜென்ரேட்டிங் கம்பெனி இன் திஸ் ஹோல் வைட் வேர்ல்ட்ல. ஆனால் எத்தனை பேருக்கு தெரியும் அவங்க வந்து இப்படி புக்ஸ் மட்டும்தான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் செல் பண்ணாங்க, அதுக்கப்புறமா படிப்படியாக முன்னேறி தென் ஒவ்வொரு இடத்துலையும் சரி அப்ப நம்ம அமேசான் வேர் ஹவுஸை ஒன்று இது பண்ணுவோம் அப்படின்னு ஒவ்வொரு இடத்துலையும் அமேசான் வேர் ஹவுஸ். அப்போ இந்த நம்ம கொரியர் எப்படி டெலிவர் பண்ணுவாங்க, இப்போ திருநெல்வேலியிலிருந்து மதுரைக்கு ஒரு பிரான்ச், தென் ஃப்ரம் மதுரை டு திண்டுக்கல், ஆர் அங்கிருந்து விழுப்புரம், அங்கிருந்து சென்னை, இந்த மாதிரி இப்படி ஒவ்வொரு ஸ்டேஷனுக்காக எப்படி அந்த ஒரு பார்சல் வந்து போகுதோ அதே மாதிரி தான் அமேசான் ஆல்சோ ஸ்டார்டட். ஸோ வென் இட் ஸ்டார்டட் லைக் தட் த டேட்டா காட் இன்க்ரீசிங் and again now big data comes into picture. அப்போ என்னடா டேட்டா நாளுக்கு நாள் நிமிஷத்துக்கு நிமிஷம் கூடிக்கிட்டே போகுது, அப்போ நம்ம வந்து டேட்டாவை நல்லா இது பண்ணுவோம். இதுக்கிடையில என்னது, மக்கள்லாம் இன்டர்நெட் வந்து ரொம்ப அதிகமாக பயன்படுத்துறாங்க, கூகுள் எஸ்பெஷலி, கூகுள் இஸ் ஆல்சோ க்ரோயிங் அப். அப்போ தென் அமேசான் ஸ்டார்ட் சிங் ஓகே, தென் வி வில் நம்மளோட எல்லா ஃபெசிலிட்டிஸும் வி வில் மேக் இன் டு கூகுள். இப்போ வந்து மொபைல் அப்ளிகேஷன்ஸும் ஸ்டார்டட் க்ரோயிங் அப், எல்லாரும் மொபைல் யூஸ் பண்றாங்கப்பா, அப்போ போடு மொபைல்ல வந்து வில் கிரியேட் அப்ளிகேஷன்ஸ். ஸோ தே ஸ்டார்டட் வித் அப்போ ஒவ்வொருத்தருக்கும் ஓகே நிறைய பேர் ஆர்டர் பண்ண ஆரம்பிச்சிட்டாங்க. அப்போ நம்மளோட டேட்டா வந்து இன்ஃபிளேட் ஆகிட்டே போகுது, நம்ம டேட்டாவை ஸ்டோர் பண்ண முடியல, டேட்டாவுக்கு செக்யூரிட்டி கொடுக்க முடியல. இப்போ உங்களுக்குலாம் தெரிஞ்சிருக்கோம் அமேசான்லாம் ஒரு 7 வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடி இருந்த கதை, நிறையா பழைய, ஸோ இட் யூ ஹவ் நோன் த ஸ்டோரி ஆஃப் அமேசான் இன் தட் பெர்ஸ்பெக்டிவ். And when Amazon then came as a big octopus, I would say. So Amazon started holding the internet like anything. So they started using Google. Even Google gets very much revenue from Amazon. They started doing this. Then as even normal people started using Amazon, maybe 7 years back down the line, if you know about Amazon, most of the products were malfunctioning products. You know, they'll be returning back, and then there will be a lot of breakages or many things. Even I myself, I'm a very frequent user of Amazon. Even I myself have experienced those. So they came up with each and everything to be resolved within minutes. Okay. So their company, so now Amazon started saying, okay, so if I need, and if people are using this much big platform, I have to now build a company. Now Amazon software company emerged. So if the software, now software technologies are also growing in. Artificial intelligence came into picture, cloud computing came into picture. So people are using, why don't we launch all our products in cloud? Most of the products that we see, you would have known now Amazon Launchpad. So there are there is something called Amazon Launchpad, which supports all the startups and all the new products, where everything is in cloud now, in AWS. Okay, so let us create lot of things which are in cloud, and people are able to make things immediately. And so DevOps came into picture. Amazon started using, and they started developing their own pictures, their own codes, and they started deploying them through DevOps. Then DevOps again pitched in. Then Bitcoin started. Okay, it is all digital money. There is no physical money coming to hand. Okay, we'll go into Bitcoin stuff. Okay, now, then side by side, Paytm, like kind of online payment gateways are also growing. Then Google also found, okay, we'll make everything fine. Let's launch this Google Pay. Many things started emerging by connecting themselves together, stitching themselves together. Okay, then now Amazon Prime. What is the difference between normal people and luxurious people? So they started, okay, let's deliver something in one day. For if you pay, they say, you give me the money, I give you the dosa. I'd like to just quote this in Tamil, okay? Kaila kaasu, vaayila dosa, okay? So that thing they said, and Prime users came into picture, Amazon Prime. How it is different? The same good, the same product, let's say a cream. The same cream has been delivered to one person in one day and the other person in 2 days. How is that possible? Through the subscriptions and your Prime subscriptions, everything that you enforce on AWS. Okay, so all our data, now data is playing a very important role. Where it is all there, now it is all in cloud because everything is now interrelated. So now Amazon became a very big giant used by multiple users. Okay, so though Google cloud platform also pitched in, Amazon entered it very early itself. So that is the reason AWS started. AWS is known to most of the people. Now Microsoft saw, oh man, Google started, Amazon started. Okay, now it's time for us to move up, right? So now Amazon, Microsoft Azure, they plunged into picture some years back. They were not focusing on much on cloud because their Windows, that is one of the most important operating system which has been utilized by almost the whole people in the world. Okay, so they were focusing more on the operating system than on other advancements. Okay, but then now Azure came into picture, and for the plus point that Microsoft had is Microsoft's own product, that is the operating system, Microsoft Windows 7 or Windows 10 or 11 now. So that has been there in all the laptops and all the computers. You say 200 billion or 300 billion people in this world, everyone is using Windows operating system. So it is very easy for Microsoft to put their product, Azure product, right, cloud product into their own operating system. But they are now full competing. So professionally, they started introducing the Azure for most of the enterprises. So here, enterprise comes into picture. So you would have known, this is like, I would like to put this topic as enterprises and network security. Everything comes one step ahead of the basics of cloud. Okay. So now revenue growth started flowing. So what Microsoft did is they focused most on the IT companies. Okay, when Amazon was focusing on normal people with AWS and Google Cloud, that time Google was focusing on their own products because Google was the first number one search engine in this whole world, right? So they were like, with the search engine itself, let me introduce the cloud platform also. So they were focusing on that. That is one track. Then Microsoft, they have their OS operating system in each and every laptop. So let me start the cloud in my own OS itself. Then Amazon, it is a very big e-commerce company, which also built its own IT industry and each and artificial intelligence or any automation or DevOps or anything. So it is one side. So three different tracks. And they want to generate their revenue, right? So how do they compete in the market? So now the business tactics comes into picture. So Microsoft mostly focused on the IT companies. Okay, so most of the companies, if you see, they are using Microsoft Azure. So wherever you would have seen this professional version of Micro Windows and individual, that is the private version of Microsoft. So whatever we are using in companies or the professional users of Microsoft. Okay. So this Microsoft Azure has been utilized by at least 48% of industries and Google Cloud Platform. So as Google is one of the very trusted companies in this whole world, and it is utilized by each and every second it has been utilized, they also introduced this private cloud and public clouds, everything to different, they say it as G Suite users. So whoever have their websites in Google, built on Google platform, whoever had this Google pictures, whoever used Google Drives, everyone can use the Google platforms. They created this called G Suite. Suite means nothing but a room. They say, you know, luxurious suite. So if you enter the G Suite, it's again costly. You have to pay some amount and buy the G Suite for 1 year or these kind of things. So if you are a G Suite user, you'll be able to access most of the GCP facilities in lesser price. Okay. So it is like, again, a luxurious room, a deluxe room in a hotel or a standard room. So these kind of things. So if you see the pricing, so as revenue and business comes into picture, so everything is circling around money again, right? So if you see how the companies are being charged, this is one of the very real revenue bills that have been taken up by Azure, and how Azure charges, GCP charges, AWS, and again, in different states, again, each and every state, how we say our own state GST or something, right? CST is there and state taxes also there. So everything now GST is there. But each and every states in US, America, they have their own counties, their own municipalities, how they charge for each and every software and everything. So that is how these three companies are playing their game in this IT industry. Okay. So each and everything, if you see here, small, medium, large, and extra large, different packages. If you take some small package, then you get some limited facilities. Again, medium, large, and extra large, it keeps going. And if you see the amount also, it varies. If you see most of the things, Amazon and Azure are very much competing with each other. But Google, if you see the GCP amount, it is very less when compared to this. You know, that is how you buy three products for 10 rupees or one product for 9 rupees. You'll obviously will go with three products for 10 rupees, right? So that kind of business tactics comes into picture here. So with that, I'd like to introduce about the types of cloud. You would have known this. This is very basic stuff like private cloud, public cloud, and hybrid. But now most of the companies are using hybrid cloud because we also can use the facilities provided by the private cloud and also make it public. Okay. So because 5-7 years down the lane, I would say, I'm from a financial background in the IT industry. Most of the companies where I worked is all telecom, finance, and insurance, all these types of domains. Okay. So I pretty much know how finance, when even I was involved in most of the bidding projects for Microsoft Azure and AWS and GCP, the time we quoted this finance, when it comes to financial domains, banking, insurance sectors, money, seems to be the playing tool. Okay, without money, nothing circles. Okay, so bank means you invest money, you make money to work for you, you make money to play for you, you give money to the people, and the same money is being invested again. So with this banking sectors, finance and other data security came as a very big question. 10 years back when I was working with IBM, even we were quoting on this cloud computing services, if how will cloud be suiting for the financial sector. So all the questions came that no, finance is very much restricted, you can't see anyone's salary, you can't see someone's ATM card or PIN or something. So cloud cannot be used by financial sector. That was the quote which was used 10 years back. But now the thing is completely changed. The thing has completely changed. So each and every financial sector has started using this hybrid. So some informations are kept very much enclosed, concealed, and some are given to the public. So how you take your own financial, let's say your bank application, HDFC, let's say. So you have your beneficiary, all these things which can be added, your IFSC code, everything can be added. Anyone can see the IFSC code, or people can know your account number. How do you get calls every now and then? Are you interested in a personal loan? Are you interested in a credit card? So these kind of informations are driven by the public cloud. While the moment you put in your customer ID, your PIN or something, and you enter your own private thing, and there is a small data storage which is being given to you, that is the private cloud. So in that storage, for example, half an hour you are browsing within your financial thing, you are adding some beneficiary, you are transferring money, you are doing some investments, everything, and then you are coming out, let's say. So then half an hour of your own private thing is being stored in private cloud. So now most of so addressing people's needs. So most of the companies started when AWS came into picture for his own need. Amazon also focused on how to ensure data security in cloud as well. So they are the pioneers, I would say, because at least most of the things, Jeff Bezos became the pioneer. Along with now, he's handshaking with Elon Musk for some of the artificial stuff. With Robo itself, how the airlines, because many countries, defense and everything comes into picture. So how to improve the security stuffs under airlines or military, all these defense, they both are shaking hands together now. So we may see in terms of in the next coming 10 years, we may see most of the things circling over this. And let's say the different models. So how I would like to just touch upon this, because most of the companies are circling around platform as a service, which is nothing but DBaaS, database as a service, because all our data, each and every moment, data is being growing, right? So where do you store all this? So data warehouse came into picture. Now data warehouse is like a big, let's say, a big container full of garbage. You will get lost, right? Let's say, for example, finance data and all, it has been stored for at least 10 years. Each and every banking data is being stored for minimum 7 years. And your own, let's say your own Facebook or your own data, your own telecom information. So let's say you want to take your telephone bill from 2009 or 2005 onwards, you will be able to. But maybe 1990s, that kind of data would not be coming. But at least after 2000, 20 years of data is at least stored. So data warehousing concepts became became bulged, I would say, where it was unable to handle. So now people thought that, okay, let's chunk this data warehousing stuff into separate data marts. So you would have known about this data mart concept, right? So each and every enterprise came in and they stored their data into small chunks. So when data marts came into picture and cloud also started evolving, they said, why don't we make this database itself be available in cloud and we'll make this as a service. So now database as a service or platform, That is the platform, because data is nothing but the base foundation for each and everything, right? And it also keeps growing. So platform as a service or database as a service is one of the most widely used models in this whole world, okay? And again, infrastructure as a service is also similar to the platform as a service. So any infrastructure, like your online services, how you have a Zoom meeting. So all the infrastructures, you are able to see others' video, you are able to share the contents, you are able to type, or you are able to send messages itself, or send a document immediately within a fraction of a second in a live call itself. You'll be able to do, right? So let's say Microsoft's Skype or anything in that matter, as in where visual communications also comes into picture. These infrastructure as a service, IaaS, also came into picture. Now people, you know, Amazon Prime is nothing but one of the very big example for infrastructure as a service. You can live stream most of the things, or Netflix live, or you can do anything in live stream, like how DTH, you just pass something and then you come back and you put it from there, right? So everything stored in your cloud databases, and it is all given. Then mobile backend services as a service, this is now emerging, but yeah, it is going to come in as a boom in another coming years, I would say. And main one more thing is serverless computing, because now compare our old IT world to new IT world. I would say now we are in new IT era. Old IT era, you know, big servers, supercomputers, you would have known about this, right? Most of the servers are supercomputers, and the servers have a real physical location and data centers all throughout the world, where lot of integrated chips, everything has been infused in them, and a physical disk or a floppy disk or something that stores the information. So finally, there was a server which was storing all this information. Now, as let's come into new world, new IT world. Now, as cloud came into picture, you can't go and search for each and, okay, in this server ID number, Mac machine ID, they say, for each and every server, there is a machine ID. In this machine, Mac ID, in this chip number, there is a lot of chips at the back end, which is in infused, okay? So in this chip number, this data is being stored. In this block number, there are many things, like, again, block storage comes into picture. So that kind of thing is now vanishing. Serverless computing, serverless computing is coming into picture now. So each and every moment when I say, yes, I'm going to do something in my laptop or something, the information is stored in cloud with a virtual machine, again, virtual ID or something, but through a serverless computing technology, okay? So in the upcoming future, as everything is getting mostly into cloud, 99% of the companies will move into cloud, so serverless computing also will come into picture. Then function as a service is nothing but most of the, it is booming up, but right now people are, let's create the platform, let's create the infrastructure, let's create all these things, then these functions as a service, everything will come into picture. Okay. So in the upcoming decade, that was most now, right now, almost 50%, I would say 47, not even 47, more than 70% has at least come into cloud. And by 2029 or in another 5 years, as per some statistics by Google, they are expecting at least 90% of the companies be moving into cloud. Then, so everything is like told, it is all enterprises and revenue related stuff. So each and every data is equal to some money, right? Each and every second is equal to money. So now, as this cloud enterprises, so that's what you say, common man and enterprises. So enterprises, they circle around different types of functionalities, and common man circle around different types of functionalities. So for each and every functionality, these companies or the countries provide That's what we use the same product. We are reason for being created. That is the thing. One common person is the reason for creation of something, and he is the main factor who is using that product also. Okay. So for people only, big data, cloud, everything came into picture, and it has been utilized for the people only. Okay. So with that into picture, most of the countries, I would say, so for example, you would have known our India it itself is going to be 95% increasing its revenue by using the IT sector. And it is found that with each and every increasing bytes of data, now it has been 175 zettabytes of data. I do not know how many digits would come in there in that zettabytes. So these much of data would be utilized. And we know that India is coming up in population also. So 150 billion people start using cloud or start using the facilities, then the revenue we generate would be far more than any other countries that have less population, right? So that's why, and we are the number one country who has the youngest, the highest youngest population, like between 35 to 45 years or 20 to 45 years people. Population is more in India. So we are expected, India is expected to generate at least 95% of revenue by using this cloud technologies and the growth. Okay. And other countries you can see. Then next comes the different, again, this slide also tells about how much percentage of people would be using. So again, global 33% of global respondents would use edge computing. Here I would like to tell you about edge computing. So when we said about this cloud, now like I quoted an example of a ration shop or an ATM for each and every house, right? So let's say your ATM machine is given to your own, let's say your own living room. You have your wallet in your living room, you have your wallet, one more gajana or your treasury in your bedroom. Let's say an ATM machine is provided, two to ATM machines for one home. How would the services be? Won't you feel so happy? So that is what is edge computing says. One more still smaller fragment of cloud technology, or still giving all the facilities to each and every functionality. As server and network connectivity or a data security, the database, data storage, and anything to the people immediately, to the people in the sense your subscriptions. Okay, so again, money also comes into picture here. Maybe people may bring it as free things, commodities in the coming near future, but now due to some subscriptions again. Like for example, Amazon Prime and normal Amazon. So how Amazon Prime is able to deliver the same Amazon delivery centers. Okay, I just like to quote this because you can relate this with your day-to-life activities. So Amazon delivery centers are available at every district at least. Okay, if you see in Tuticorin, it would be there, or Tirunelveli or Madurai or these kind of centers, Amazon delivery centers are there, and that's where the goods come. Okay, so let's say I'm from Bangalore, I'm sending something to Jenny ma'am there in Tirunelveli. So my good would be coming there Madurai or to till Dindigul, then from there to Madurai, the Amazon delivery center takes up, then from there to Tirunelveli, and then from there the Amazon guys go and deliver to the physical location. But the same product, let's say same inventory, if I'm ordering through my Amazon Prime subscription, let's say Amazon Prime costs at least more than $500 per year, I think around 700 to 900 something. So I do not have the subscription. So the same product is able to reach Madam Jenny in one day. How is that possible? How is the same product from the same supplier, let's say, reaches to the end user in one day using one subscription, but it takes at least 5 days to reach for normal subscription. So that is where this edge computing and all other different facilities also comes into picture. They have their inventory, their consignments as a storage itself in some of the, Amazon plays a lot of business tactics. They clearly distinguishes the rich and yet to become rich, okay? So they clearly do this distinction. They have a storage, okay? The storage centers are also there. I do not know if you had been to see a delivery center, you would know there are bulk storages of some materials as well. You know, daily used goodies like a shampoo bottle or a cream or a thing which has been utilized, like Amazon grocery, let's say. So they have some bulk quantity, and when they see this Prime subscription, immediately it's been given. So likewise, edge computing is also coming into picture. It will boom in another 10 years. Okay. So now with all these, let's say cloud has been evolving as a big technology giant in this IT giant or IT industry. How cloud can be still further utilized? That has been going to happen in this 10 years. So how we know IoT, artificial intelligence, DevOps, all these things were utilized by a physical server or database some years back. Now everything is going to be utilized by cloud technology. So as and when something booms, you know that IoT, Internet of Things, I can connect to your own meeting through this Google Meet link, right? If my Google Meet link is open in my laptop, I connect through a laptop. If my Google Meet link is opened in my mobile, I connect through mobile. So at the same time, I can come online in multiple devices through internet. So Internet of Things come into picture. So the similar way you would have known about the robotics, RPA, they say robotics process of automation. That is also coming up. How people became lazy, they started inventing robots, right? For Amazon Echo Dots, Alexa. The moment Alexa, you switch on Alexa, hey, Alexa, turn on the computer. Alexa, please switch on the... we have not yet seen those kind of lights. You would have seen Dhoni, our beloved Dhoni, coming in for Philips advertisements, right? You just switch on with a remote, the fan functions. So how does it happen? So are you connect through your internet, through that there is a mobile application. If you had bought this Alexa or Echo Dot, you would know. We recently bought it, but then we were not finding much use of that because most of our things are not connected to internet, only the computer, the songs. So let's say Alexa, please connect to a song in Ghana. Means from Ghana app, automatically it will play you the song. You just need to tell, you just play me Janaganamana, let's say India's national anthem. Then it immediately searches and it plays. But now in America and all, they are, the home itself is coming as robot controlled homes, okay? So either CCTV camera or because security, again, CCTV, because, you know, American lifestyle is a little bit different. The kids stay in the in different rooms and then parents in different rooms, and beyond the house, there is always large spaces. So mainly they utilized the IoTs for surveillance cameras to monitor people's movement everywhere. And now, IoT infused lights and heaters, everything has come into picture. You know, you would have seen some advertisements of AO Smiths and all. The heater turns from your mobile application. So that is nothing but IoT. So all these information where you'll be storing now, as let's say the physical databases, data mounts, everything is vanishing. Only cloud is there. Serverless computing has come. So all these things again need to come to cloud technology, right? So that is where IoT will play a very important role in cloud technology. So when IoT comes into picture, DevOps will come into picture. So when DevOps, again, immediately, whenever people's need, each and everything comes up, automatic deployment will come into picture. So for each and everything, enterprises will come, okay, let me deliver all your codes in 2 minutes only, in 2 seconds only. So DevOps will come into picture. So when all these things comes into picture, artificial intelligence will come into picture. So with each and everything, how to automate or how to read people's mind, and before you think only, everything is given to you. Literally, you know, people are not allowed to think, I would say, with all these advancements. Positive thing is, it is all advancements, and we are we can boost up our collar and say, yay, we are living in internet era. But you know, we are, our thinking capacity is becoming lesser. Until unless you go and break your head, you squeeze your brain and find some code, you are thinking. But when you are using some code, you are using someone's product, and you are becoming addicted to that code, or you are becoming addicted to Amazon, or you are becoming addicted to a cloud technology, right? You are becoming addicted to live streamings. So these kind of things have both plus and minus, but it is all, we have to use it for our own beneficial. So when artificial, I would like to connect this into picture, when artificial intelligence comes into picture, robots comes into picture. So when robotics comes into picture, all the countries, I mean, now a bigger picture, let's say from a smaller circle, let's move into a bigger picture. Just imagine country India is there, country America, USA is there, Russia, China, North Korea. Okay, these are the most emerging, or these are the countries which will be spoken up at least for another next 20 to 30 years. Okay, and no wonder we will be coming into a most well-developed country in the coming years. Okay, so these countries are investing a lot in nuclear power, right? Because to show that who is going to win the show, now you would have known the economic connectivity, economic war between, the silent war happening between US and China, right? So who will win the show, that comes into picture. So advancements, when military defense, everything comes into picture, also you step out into Moon and Mars. That's what Elon Musk has told, we are going to send a robo puppy to Mars. That's what Elon Musk has said, and they both, Amazon, Jeff Bezos and Elon Musk, you know, Tesla cars, right, automatic auto-driven cars, they are all now getting into picture. They are going to send some robo, a small puppy dog to Mars, it seems. That was the thing they are saying. So robotics comes into picture. So if you see cloud, edge computing, robotics, artificial intelligence, everything are going to boom in the next coming 10 years. So for all this, some codes or some programming languages, right, where it is all related, everything is stitched together, and someone has to write the code, right? Yes, you open Amazon app, once you enter your user ID and password, you open Amazon app. Who wrote that code? We IT guys, right? So when, as an engineering student or a technological background student, we are going to focus on most of the codes which will go to do this all functionalities in the bigger picture. So in the back end, either a programming language, most of the codes are written in C, C++, two under, okay? So Python, now you know that Python is getting into picture, but how you will put forth, that is one of the things. C, C++ and all, how it has lost, it's because C, C++ are very good languages, I would say. When we started our laboratory exercises, we started with C, C++ program, but it is restricted to certain very limited quantity. Now, Python as a big giant, I would say coding giant, it came in, and Python is available everywhere. You have your free Python, you can get your own codes, Python copyrighted codes, can be utilized for anyone, okay? So you can put in your codes. Java again comes into picture. With Java, JSON scripts and neural language processings, all these things, Python can be together, made together and instructed. Python, lot of algorithms, that's where the algorithms comes into picture. Natural language processing algorithms to make people's work easy. So everything is now available, but how do you host it? You write a program or do something, but how are you going to make it work for you? Through some open source software. So open OSS, we say, right? So open source, nothing but, for example, I would quote our Unix, our shell scripts, kernel shell scripts. The KSH scripts have that much power to do whatever you want to do. You know, you can connect with a Java applet or SAP through SAP different interfaces, APIs you can connect. Through Python you can connect. You can write the PowerShell scripts. Now it has evolved in as PowerShell scripts. You can write many things you can do using this open source software. So when we speak about all this cloud, IoT, robotics, artificial intelligence means, and coding, algorithms again, now open source software comes into picture. So let's say different things. So this slide gives you about different open source softwares which are available. Like for example, Firefox, even Firefox and our Internet Explorer, you know, among that Firefox is one of the things which is written in open source software. You would have known in Internet Explorer, many things will not open. Even in my company, we have seen in Internet Explorer, many things doesn't open at all. But whereas in Firefox, many things open, you know, the restrictions are loosened in Firefox. Because if you see back and if you dig deep how Firefox codes are written, it would have used some open source software. Okay, and MySQL's now different DBs or MongoDB you would have heard. So these are things like it is all connected, going to be connected with open source software. So like this different technologies to balance. So everything is now coming, now speed comes into picture, right? So speed, when you see the speed, our latest computers, if you see for human use, you would have known only how much RAM of space, at least 8 GB to 10 GB of RAM is being utilized by most of the computers. Even our phones, they come up with 10 GB RAM. In the moment you click something, everything works very fast. The system doesn't hang. But there are enterprises and which use this cloud, no? Cloud, they have almost 30 GB RAM to 32 or I think almost 64 GB RAM it itself is going to come. I do not know the upper limit, but the speed, that's what the RAM, random accessible memory, right? So the RAM and the speed is getting into picture. So if you are a core guy, like I would say an electronics and instrumentation engineering person or a mechanic, I do not know about mechanical engineering, but something ECE department, you can build your own diodes, your own integrated chips, which will give a better speed quality. We can invent many things. Now, how Intel everywhere, right? Intel is inside everywhere. So Intel, how did they come? They came up with different integrated chips, different diodes that will process input and output very fast. So everything is interrelated. So no matter if you are a computer science engineering, you are an E&I, electronics and instrumentation, or electronics and communication, or any other, I'm unable to relate the different things. You can connect all the departments or all the engineering students together to at least contribute in some pattern. So we are in need of the enterprises in need of good speed integrated chips. So that industry will be booming up in another next 10 years. Okay. Then comes again automation. I have spoken up many times. Again, automation will be increased by 70% at least by 2029. Then I would like to say, though the slides are over, I would like to enforce that even in our company, we have already started using natural language processing along with cloud. We are already into cloud for the past 3 years at least, 3 to 5 years, I would say. Before 5 years itself, the cloud, 2015 itself, it started emerging. And now we are already into automation. So when we are speaking about insights of cloud itself, many companies are already automating things through cloud. We work in cloud and my own team members, we are doing, there is some tool called FlexiCapture. You can Google and see. It automatically reads from a PDF and it stores all the information back in the cloud. It creates my domain is now at the insurance backend. So it creates policies. All, you know, some very big insurance giants are writing policies every 30 minutes. For just 30 minutes, some insurance policies are written and signed by the person through cloud now. Okay, so like that, many advancements are coming in. So to gel up everything together, when we say, I'm going to wrap up the session. So when we gel up everything together, cloud insights will be a boom, in the sense, if you are a computer science engineering, just focus on how are you going to enforce all these codings, your algorithmic talents, your skills, everything to make or to get the cloud into picture. Or if you're very much interested, I'm going to do some automation. Check in terms of automation perspective, if you're a database interested guy, check, okay, how the data mods or how the data blocks, okay, mostly in cloud, it is all saved in block wise. Block computing, you would have heard, or block or chunks, okay? So how to still make the things feasible? Or if you're easy guy, I had been always getting some calls or into my mailbox like, ma'am, I'm an easy guy, will I get an opportunity in the IT world? Yes, you will be able to get. Easy guys are the ones who are able to host a laptop, right? You develop your own diodes, you develop your own input output journals, you do your own mix and match, you come up with some invention. So with your invention, we'll be the computer IT world will be working on. So never ever shrink your ideas. Okay, with that, I would like to complete this session. So insights of cloud will circle around IoT, automation, open source, because serverless computing or edge computing will boom up. Then robotics and other backend things like a Bitcoin or a blockchain, all these things will be supporting cloud. So it is all like interrelated. Cloud is there, all these automations, everything, your neural language or natural language processings, then your comes database, data mining concept, security, again, computer, networks comes into picture, everything is interrelated. So with this, I'd like to close this session. Thank you so much for this opportunity. And I would be very much pleased to have your feedback given to your concerned respective faculty. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful speech. So we can move. Yes, now I invite Jennifer, ma'am, to offer the vote of thanks.
Thank you, ma'am, for the wonderful session. First of all, I thank our almighty God for giving such a wonderful informative session. Then I thank our eminent resource person and my friend Sharon for spending his valuable time with us. Next, I thank our management and our HOD ma'am, Professor Brinda, for providing their guidance. Then I thank all the participants for their presence. Finally, but not the least, I thank all the faculty members who provide the support in the smooth conduct of this webinar. Thank you once again. Thank you all.